Well, hello everyone. Welcome to Back to Viz Basics, Flourish Edition. Yay! We're going to make some graphs in Flourish this week. We are asked to make a unit chart. So a unit chart is just going to be some ordering of icons or objects or shapes to show each individual object. I'm not going to go into details about whether these are good graphs or bad graphs. The whole idea is just to learn how to make this kind of graph in Flourish. And as you're going to see, there's multiple ways to do this, and I'm not sure what the best way is, so we'll just play around and figure it out together. Okay, so the data we have is how many glasses of water we should be drinking according to age, gender, and what is called in the description, condition. So that's going to be whether a pregnant woman, lactating woman, teen, elderly, kids. That's the sort of data that we're looking at. The data is provided by Evian. That's kind of an interesting choice. We have five variables in the data set: demographic, total water intake in liters, water from beverages in liters, glasses, 250 milliliters each, and the unit. I think the unit is the total number of glasses that we're supposed to drink by category. And that's the one that I'm going to use. I think that's what it is. The data set's not totally well documented, but it's okay. Like, we're just learning how to make this here, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. So here's the data that we have. As you can see here, let's just look at the ages for the kids. You can see we have total water intake, water, glasses, and unit. So as you can see here, I think the unit is just the maximum number of glasses. So it's really the last row of each grouping that I'm particularly interested in using. So I'm going to create two separate data sets I'm going to use in Flourish. The first one is just going to be the number of glasses, the maximum number of glasses for each of these different categories. Again, you can see we have kids, 9 to 13 year old girls and boys, teens, adults, men and women, pregnant women, lactating women, and then elderly men and women. I just use a fun little max ifs function to kind of just pull this data over. That's not a Flourish thing, just kind of a fun little, I don't get to use max ifs very often, so I got to use that in Excel. That was kind of fun. And then I also just did a little copy and pasting here to break this out. I wanted to play around a little bit by grouping these separately. So I've got one row for each group, and then I've got a column for both genders. So that's three categories. Women and girls, that's five categories. And then for men and boys, that's three categories as well. So that's the data that we're going to look at. Let's head back over to the visualizations. So I've made two, one icon table, one a pictogram. Here's the pictogram. I ended up not 100% loving this, but let me show you what I did here, how you create this. So when you pick the pictogram out, there's multiple options in Flourish. This is what the data looks like. So you pop your data in the same way as you usually do. And then there's an icons tab. And here the icons are going to link to your data using this ID column. So that's the key. And you're probably looking at this the way I did, which is, what is this code? Well, if you're a designer, you probably know. I didn't know this. I had to do some research. There is a nice help document that Flourish provides. These are SVG codes. So when you have an editable image in an SVG format, you can get the code from it, and the code pops into here. So how do you get that SVG code? Well, at least the way Flourish recommends is you drop whatever your SVG icon is. I grabbed an icon from the Noun Project. Drop it into, they recommend Figma, but lots of other tools could do this as well, and copy the code out of it. So if you haven't used Figma, it's a free tool, nice for making slides, presentations, wireframes, fun designs, all that sort of good stuff. So I grabbed this icon from the Noun Project, saved it out as an SVG, brought it into Figma, and then all I need to do here is right click and say copy paste as SVG. And I copy that code and I'm going to drop it into this text file. And so here's a text file. And now what I need to do here is just take the text in between the quotation marks. Okay, so that's the key. You don't need all the other stuff. I ran into that trouble a little bit. So I just grabbed the stuff inside the quotation marks. And we're going to take that and we're actually going to remake this. So here's the original, by the way, that they start you off with. We're not going to use that. So I'm just going to pop in this code right here. And I'm just going to pop this in a whole bunch of places to get us started, even though I need the data. So let's go grab the data. We're going to start here. Let's go back. Drop my data in here. Copy and paste. Just something that I kind of learned here. Because the unit column right now is not being used, you can't remove this column. So if I click remove, I get an error. So you just have to kind of turn that off first. So I'm not going to use C, I'm actually going to use B, and now I can remove that column. Small thing, but these are the things that, you know, keep us busy, I guess. Okay, so we're going to go back over here. Notice that the ID isn't copied over there. So we're going to have to copy this column, just the values, and we'll drop them in here and make sure I have all of it in. And I don't think I have everything in here. So I need to, put in more of these codes. I'm just going to, there we go. Just going to copy down. And let's see, I'm getting closer here. Let's see. I've got everything in. I'm good. Now, the other thing that happens is you need to put in the width and the height of the icon. So let me just show you what the preview looks like right now. Totally strange. And that's because it's not sized correctly. So let's go back to our code. This is a key piece that took me a bit to figure out. You need to go in and grab the width and height here. Right from here, you're just going to use that. So 1025 and 1106. So 1025 and 1106. And you just have to do this separately. So I'm just going to copy and paste, because I'm going to use the same icon for this example. And I'm going to bring this all the way down. And so now we should be getting a little bit closer. There we go. That's looking a little bit better. So we've got the data in, but you can see it took a little bit of work. So it's not super simple. I don't love the way this is looking, so I'm going to flip this and make it horizontal. That's looking good. As you can see here, I don't want all this stuff on this graph. So let's just do some changes here. Let's get rid of a few things at the top. So the value legend, I don't need that. I don't need really any of the legends on this. I'm going to get rid of that. And we'll get rid of that label there at the top. I also want to make these labels a little bit bigger. So let's go to bar labels right here. Let's make this a little bit bigger. Try two. Let's pick a color. I'm going to pick like a blue color, a dark blue color. I'll show you why in a moment. Okay, that's a blue color. So let's do the colors here. Because I sort of thought about this, how am I going to do this? Well, I think the way I want to do it is I want to have one color for girls and women, a separate color for boys and men, and then a separate color for the kids. So if we go into colors, it just picks this palette. And instead of like using codes or restarting, I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to edit this color palette. So let's say, for example, we want to keep the same purple for the first three groups. So I'm just going to copy and paste that purple. I think I want to use this blue, so I'm going to hold on to that for a second. Okay, so I've got purple for the top three. And then let's just use orange and blue for the girls and boys. So the orange will be the women and the girls. And I'm just going down my list here. And one more down here. Oh, I went too far. There's the orange, and we'll use the blue for the boys and the men. And I think that's right, and I'll get rid of that last color. And that's looking pretty, pretty good. So, okay, we're on our way. Let's do a header here. I already have one, so I'm just gonna go grab it from over here. How much water should people drink per day? I'm trying to get better with my titling here. I like the basic size. I'm gonna grab the subtitle here. I don't like this default size, it's way too big. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to, if you click here under size, you can make it smaller or bigger. I want it even smaller. So I click the three dots and then I can just click down. I think I end up picking like 1.05, something like that. So I like that. And the last thing I want to do is get rid of this demographic word. And then I have to figure out where that is. This is the thing. It took me a while to sort of find this. It took me a bit. I think it's on the axis. That's it. Click custom. It's not on or off. It's auto or custom. Think about that. So custom, and then just leave it blank. And that's the graph. It's fine. It's pretty straightforward. I mean, maybe the icon isn't great, but let's try another visualization, the icon table. So this is what we're going to do at the end here. Here's the icon table. You can see that I had a little fun here. I won't lie to you. So I'm going to open up my folder again, and I'm going to bring in a new icon table just to show you. Whenever you start a new graph in Flourish, what's great is that when you go down here, it already has a visualization in there, so you can sort of learn how to create it. So this is actually what they call a bingo card, although it's in the table, and then when you open it, it kind of looks like a table in my folder, so I'm not sure about that. So here's the bingo card. If you go over here, you can see the data is just set up with rows, and these are just emojis. So if you just open your emoji keyboard, these are just emojis. So I'll just pop a couple of happy faces in here. And then when you go back over to your table, you can see they're popped right in there. So that's pretty simple. What I wanted to do was bring this visualization over into my icon table. And so I started playing around with markdown code. But as you're going to see, I basically made my image. I shrank it down. I loaded it up to my own site so I could grab the URL. But when it came in here, you can see that the sizes aren't quite right. The first one is just different than the other three, and I couldn't get them aligned in a row. I don't know what's going on here. I can't get the markdown to work. So I'm hoping that maybe someone from Flourish will let us know how to get this in here, make it a little bit easier to upload my own icons into the table. I want my own icon in the table. So let's turn that off. So I'm just going to say, let's just go to letter D. And then here, now I've done a bit. I just used an icon here. And there's not like, unfortunately, there's not like a glass of water. If you do glass in here, you get like glass of whiskey and glass of milk. I don't know why there's not a glass of water. If you do water here, there's a drop. That I started to think about might be okay. I put this kind of faucet. I did that. So that's the one that I used. I also put the number in here, and I'm going to go back. And as you can see, the number's at the end. I don't love the number, so I'm just going to delete. So all I'm doing here is basically I brought in my data and kind of manually just entered these icons. Now, you could do that in Excel using the repeat function. So you could build this in Excel and then just copy and paste it over here. I didn't really bother with that. So as you can see, I bring this in. There are a few things that I needed to change. I'm not going to remake this because it is pretty straightforward. I put the cell headers, I centered them and made them bold. I did add the grid lines behind it. As you can see, I put them on both vertical and horizontal dimensions. I did make these column widths equally spaced. The last thing I did, as you can see, was add this little picture behind it. And I played around with some ideas here, but I wanted it's a very straightforward table, right? So I wanted to add a little bit of something here and to learn how to do it. So to do this, I went into the layout tab, and here I have to, I'm just gonna load up my visualization, or load up my picture. So all I have to do here is just grab the image URL. So how did I do that? I went to Unsplash, unsplash.com, my favorite photo website, which is just ironic, coincidental that it's splash and water, and grabbed this photo, but it was too dark when I popped it into this visualization. So I brought it into PowerPoint. Here's the original graph. Actually, the original graph was this, but I wanted the water at the top. So I flipped it upside down, and then I put a transparent white box on top of it, and then I exported it out as a picture. And then I brought the picture into here, put it behind, made my grid lines a little bit darker, and I am going to export and republish that visualization. And that is my unit chart in Flourish. So let me know what you think. Share your visualizations. Use the hashtag B2VB on Twitter, LinkedIn, all your social medias. Reach out to me. Let me know how you're doing with Flourish, what your frustrations, what things you're discovering. It's a really fun tool. I'm starting to learn a lot. And make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can learn more about creating visualizations in Flourish, Excel, PowerPoint, all your favorite data visualization tools. Thanks for watching. See you next time.